Hi guys, I'm Jasmine, the IELTS faculty at People's Overseas. Today I'm here to give you some more tips and tricks regarding IELTS as I always do. The topic on which I'll be giving you some tips today is listening. Listening module. It is a very important module, and if you know the right keys and right tips, you can score a really high score in your listening module. So let's begin, shall we? The very first tip is very basic, and I think everyone should know this, is that you always should use pencil. In your listening module, always use pencil. Pencils are always helpful. If you get the spelling wrong, you can erase and you can write it again. Secondly, now most people are confused if they should write in capital letters or lowercase letters. You can write in either one, but you need to be careful with one thing. If you start writing in capital one, then you should continue in capital letters only. If you start writing in lowercase, then you should continue with lowercase. Don't mix these two up. It will confuse the checker. Now the next thing you need to remember is that sometimes the audio will be some monotonous audio, and you won't get all the answers serial wise. What happens, you got the answer of question 1, you got the answer of question 2, but then you keep listening and there is no answer. The audio is going on, but you can't get the answer. This can happen. There can be gaps in your answer. So it is perfectly natural. Do not panic. Next thing. Spelling is actually very important when it comes to listening test. In colleges, we have forgotten these. We just make notes. We just try to write everything down, but we forget that spelling is important. Well, in listening test, if you get the spellings wrong, it can cost you your marks. The next thing you need to be careful with is don't try to understand everything, both in listening and reading. Do not try to understand what is given or what they are saying. Just find answers. When you are doing your test in listening module or in reading module, your job is to find answers, and that is all. You do not need to understand everything at all. The next thing you should need, you should be careful with is that most students get confused whether they should write the preposition or not. Well, it depends on the question type. If you get the question, first read the instruction, how many words you should write. If they say 2 words and no more than that, or if they say 3 words or no more than that, then you need to be careful. If your 2 words does not consist of a preposition, then do not write it. If they are like 3 words and you have to add a preposition, you can add a preposition, and you think it will be suitable, then add the preposition. Also, it depends on the question type. For example, if you're filling a form and they say place is equal to dash, and you have the answer hospital, so you can just write hospital. You don't need to write at the hospital, in the hospital. But if it is some sentence completion, for example, his uncle is dash, so then you have to write at the hospital or in the hospital, right? So this is how you use prepositions in your listening test. Next thing, always say this, but again I'm saying this, familiarize yourself with English language. Try to familiarize yourself with different accents, Australian accents, British accents, and American accents at most, because the audio speakers will be use different accents. They could be on same accent if you are lucky, but they can be different as well. So be sure to practice with that as well. Not only that, if you need any extra help, guys, you should register with us for our online classes. Yes, People Overseas now providing online classes as well at flexible hours. So register with us with the link given in the bio. Thank you, guys. This would be all for today. Thank you.